Can a 1050 Ti play Star Citizen? That is the question for today. Over the last few weeks, we've been in a bit of a series trying to find out the low-end spec, the real minimum spec for the game. We've tried different CPUs, and today it's the turn of the 1050 Ti. I'm hopeful that this will be what we've been looking for, because spending much more money than this will be bad. So, without further ado, let's get into the benchmarks. So here we go, into space with the 1050 Ti, and you can see that with the 5900X, you are not bottlenecked in any way at 720p. It's nearly matching the 3080. You can see then when you pop it into the i5 system, it does drop considerably, and then also drops again when you actually up it to 1080p. So interesting results. They're pretty good. If you were averaging 50, you'd be pretty happy, but unfortunately it doesn't stay this positive. Looking at Art Corp, and you see quite consistent results here between the i5 and the 5900X, both at 720p and at 1080p, which is basically confirming that we are GPU bottlenecked at this point. So they're pretty decent results. Again, at 1080p, you'd be pretty happy if you could play the game all the time at 35fps. Lying in bed in Everest Harbor, there's a big difference between the 5900X and the i5, but actually the 1080p results are fine here, in either case, whether you're a bit CPU bottlenecked by the i5 or you're on the 5900X, both those frames there are pretty good. Louisville always throws up some interesting results, and you can see the clear scaling between the i5 and the 5900X. The 5900X is doing a much better job than the i5, so we'll ignore the i5 results for this one. And really, the 1050i shows quite a big difference between 720p and 1080p, which is showing that it is really being pushed. And there are parts of this run that are quite GPU intensive, on the train, for instance, and it's borderline playable. Area 18, the plaza, and the picture is becoming clearer. At 720p, we're getting a result that matches a 3080. But when you up the 1050 Ti to 1080p, it almost halves and becomes barely playable. So the picture is becoming clear. It's not doing particularly well at 1080p at all. Quantum travel, one of the more intensive parts of the game graphically, and the picture again is the same. 720p, pretty decent. 1080p, not so great. Doesn't matter if you're on the 5900X or the i5, we're not CPU bottlenecked on this test. Calliope's weather effects are probably the most GPU intensive part of the game that I could find, at least. And again, it's hammering everything here, but really 720p at 25fps is decent. The 1080p results, not great at all. Wally's Bar, the last result and the worst result. It's not fun to play this game at 16fps, which is what you get at 1080p. So there we have it, there are the results. So can the 1050 Ti run the game? I'm going to say no, at least not at an acceptable resolution. For me, 720p, at least on a big monitor, it's a mess. It's a real blurry mess. It looks like you're playing some sort of PlayStation or N64 game. It's horrible. Knowing that Star Citizen is such a beautiful game and that's what a lot of people are drawn into, I don't think I could recommend you dropping down to 720p. You'd lose so much of the experience. So I don't think that's good enough. And that's a shame, because it's cost £130, this graphics card. It's very popular on the Steam hardware list. It's kind of just below the 1060 Ti at 1060. And also it's so popular that Nvidia have just started reselling them, making them again, because they can't make enough of the new GPUs. So I was hopeful. My hope was in this one. I thought this was the chosen one. Turns out it was not. So where do we take this minimum spec PC series from here? Well, the only real option is to get another graphics card. As much as my wife doesn't understand why I keep buying lots of graphics cards, we've got to try and find one that will play the game at 1080p. I think that is the minimum. I don't think we can recommend anything lower than that. So I've been on eBay. I've done what you shouldn't do. I panicked. I saw one that I thought was a good deal. Turns out it wasn't a good deal. I've paid £160 for an RX 570, which if it's arrived by the time I put this video out, it might appear here. But that is the next hope. It's considerably quicker than the 1050 Ti in most benchmarks that I've looked at online. So we'll hope that that will be the one that we can recommend as the low-end minimum spec GPU for Star Citizen. So that will be next week. But if you're enjoying this sort of stuff, if you like this sort of more technical look at Star Citizen, subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like. And when I get to 100,000 Twitch followers, I'm going to get a tattoo of Chris Roberts' face on my foot. So come and follow me on Twitch. See you soon.